Hello everyone, welcome you all. So in the previous videos we were discussing about assertions in Python unit test. So in this video I'm going to discuss about two kinds of assertions. One is assert in, assert not in. Okay, now assert in is a assertion verifies whether the first element is present in the second element. If the first element is present in the second element, then test passed, otherwise test is failed. Similarly, so assert not in method verifies whether the first element is not present in the second element or not. If the first element is present in the if the first element is present, then test will be failed, otherwise test will be passed. So these assertions can be used and helpful when you want to verify the presence of the value in a list, tuple, set or dictionary data structures in Python. Now let us see practically how we can use this assert in, assert not in. Let me just open my PyCharm and here I will create a new Python unit test file. So here I will just say assertion test 4. All right, so now here I will demonstrate two types of assertions. One is assert in, the other one is assert not in. So to do this, I will just import unit test. I'll import just a unit test, and here I'm not going to deal with any Selenium WebDriver code, so I don't require Selenium package. So I'll just import only unit test. Now here I will create one class. This is a class test, and this test class should be extended from the test case class, which is from unit test. So I'll say unit test dot test case. Unit test dot test case. And here inside this class I will create a method. Let's say test underscore name, some method is required, and in this method I will just create, observe this, I'm just creating a list variable and which contains some values. So some, let's say some list of values. Let's say I create something called Python, and there is another value, I will just say Selenium, and I will also specify one more value, let's say Java. So currently I have three list items in this variable. So this can be either list or dictionary or set. You can use any kind of data structure, so which contains some values. All right, so now by using assert command, by using this assert in command, I want to verify a specific value is present in this list variable or not. Okay, so now I can do that, like check, I want to verify this Python is present in this list or not. To do this, I can use self.assert in. So this is a method I can use, self dot assert in. So this command or this assertion will verify the whatever. Here we need to pass two parameters. So one is what we are going to verify. So this is a value we are verifying, which is a part of this list variable or not. And the second parameter is a variable name. Second parameter is a variable name. Now this assert command will verify whether this particular value is present in this list or not. If it is present, then it returns true, our test case will pass. If it is not part of this list, then it returns false, our test case will be failed. Now let us run this code, and before running this, I will just create a main condition to execute this test case as a module. Now I can say if underscore underscore name underscore underscore equal to the double quotes underscore underscore main underscore underscore. And if this condition is true, I'm running my unit test dot main. All right, so now I'm running this one, unit test. So one more T is required. All right, so now observe this. So this particular assertion command will verify this particular string is present in this list or not. If it is present, it returns true, that means our test case will be passed. Now here, as per our expectation, our test method should be passed. Now let's run this code, and now so ran one test, and what has happened, it is getting failure. Why it is getting failure? Let us verify why it's getting failure here. Okay, so here this is an error it is giving. Python is not found in this list. So why it is not found? Because we have done the spelling mistake here, right? So here I'll just say proper Python, right? So now it is perfect. Now it will verify this string is present in the list or not. Now let us run this code one more time. All right, so now it is getting executed and now it is passed. All right, so what does it mean is, Assert in is an assertion which will check whether this particular value is present in the list variable or not. If it is available, then our test method will pass. If it is not available, then our test method will be failed. So for example, instead of Python, I will just say some other value. Let me just create one more. Instead of Python, I will just say Ruby. Okay, now Ruby is not part of this list, right? Now in this case, it should fail. So now it is getting failed. Alright, so this is a one condition, positive condition, whether our string is present in this variable or this value is present in this variable or not. If it is present, our test method will pass, and if it is not present, our test method will be failed. And similarly, we have another condition, assert not in, that is opposite of this. Self dot assert not in, not in. What this will do is, this is again completely opposite of it. So it will verify whether the string is present in this list or not. If the string is present in that list, then it will return false. If the string is not present in the list, then it will return true. Okay. So for example, same thing I'm using now. Observe this, the difference between these two commands. So when I say these two, what happens? This is returns true. It is passed. Now in this case, this is failed. Right, so because Ruby is not part of the list, so assert in is verifying it is not part of the list, it is getting failed. Now here if I use the same thing by using assert not in, then it will be passed because Python is part of the list. But what we are expecting, assert not in, we are expecting not in, but Python is in the list, so it is there in the list, so it will fail. So this test case will be failed. Now let's run this code and see. Now our test case is failed. So Python is unexpectedly found in this one. So unexpectedly found means Python is already there here. So that's the reason internal condition is true. Now what we are expecting is not in, right? So similarly, when I say same thing, in that case, suppose if I give something, let's say this time I will say Ruby. So now what happens is the Ruby is not part of this list. If it is not part of this list, and then assert not in, assertion will be passed. Now when I run this, it will be passed. Now run one test and it is called passed. Okay, so this is a completely opposite condition. Now this is case passed. Okay, assert in, assert not in. And this assertion commands not in and in can be used with all kinds of data structures like list, set, dictionary, tuples and everything in the Python. Okay. So that's all about these assertion, assert in, assert not in. Okay, so that's all for this video. So thanks for watching this. Please subscribe my channel to get more updates on this. Thank you all.